Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Assalamu alaikum, dear students. Our current session focuses on some other terms such as system, procedure, and technique. I hope and expect by the end of this session you would be able to distinguish amongst all of these. Well, I would start with the term system. The idea of language as a system appears in the linguistic theory of Ferdinand de Saussure in Firth's works, in Benjamin Levoff's works and Helmsley's works, and also in Halliday's work. The paradigmatic principle, that is the idea that the process of using language involves choosing from a specifiable set of options, was established in semiotics by Saussure. What does it mean? It means that he believed that in our mind, we have a set of, we have a collection of different options, different possibilities. And when it comes to language use, the learner opts from or chooses from these available options. His concept of value was the concept of valuer and of signs as terms in a system showed up paradigmatic organization as the most abstract dimension of meaning. You know, where different options are available, and out of those options, within that system, the learner picks up the most appropriate one in a particular situation. System is used in two related ways in systemic functional linguistics that we sometimes call SFL. SFL uses the idea of system to refer to language as a whole, that is, the system of language. Well, what is important to understand when we talk about the system of language is, since language, according to Saussure, is a system of signs, what do we mean by a system of signs? Signs work in collaboration with each other. I would just quickly give you an example of traffic lights. So a red traffic light or a yellow traffic light or a green traffic light, each one of these has a meaning, but these lights have certain meanings of stopping or of continuing the journey or getting ready to start the journey, for example, for the yellow light. These meanings that are attached to these lights, they work within the system of traffic light signals. In the same way, in language, you know, different signs have different meanings, both when it comes to phonologically pronouncing them or morphologically representing them in the form of writing. But these meanings operate within the system. This usage actually derives from Helmsley's works. There is also the notion of system as it is used by Firth, where linguistic systems are considered to furnish the background for elements of structure. So the linguistic units or the systems, they provide the basic structures of language that operate within the whole system of language. With this, we come to the next term, that is procedure, and we need to understand it in comparison and contrast with the term system. Okay, a procedure is by definition an established way of doing something. When you do something according to the process that is acceptable or the process that is established for that, the process that is used for that, we call it a procedure. We may define it as a set of actions conducted in a certain order or manner. So doing certain things in a certain sequence, in a certain way, following one another, this is what is a procedure. When it comes to linguistic procedures or processes, it refers to a process involved in human language. So how different processes are sequenced or are involved in the production of language in a particular situation. In fact, a linguistic process may refer to the cognitive processes involved in producing and understanding linguistic communication. We also need to compare and contrast this idea of procedure to technique. So far, what we have understood is a system is, you know, a set of rules or a set of certain ways of doing certain things within language, whereas a procedure is the process of sequencing them when it comes to their use. Now we need to look at another term, that is a technique. A technique is a way of carrying out a particular task, especially the execution or performance of an artistic work or a scientific procedure. A technique is implementation that actually takes in place in a classroom. So when it comes to the classroom, a technique is a very small unit. There can be, for instance, many techniques within a method. So, you know, technique is a very low level of execution, I would say. One particular way of executing something at a time point is one technique. And by using various techniques, for example, a method can be executed in the classroom. In other words, it's a particular trick, stratagem, or contrivance used to accomplish an immediate objective. For example, in a classroom, when a teacher wants to teach a particular linguistic item, let us take the example, if the teacher wants to teach the use of imperatives in the classroom, for that the teacher can use different techniques. One technique can be where the teacher would give an order to certain students in the classroom. Go and close the door. Sit down. Stand up. Show me your work. So, you know, one technique is to demonstrate it through the use of these imperatives in the classroom. Techniques must be consistent with a method, and therefore they should be in harmony with an approach as well. Well, a common technique when using video materials is called silent viewing, where the teacher plays a video and silently it is viewed by the audience.